Collections define a set of related attributes required for the data collection process. For example, you could create a collection for lease information with attributes such as lease number, property address, expiration date, and lease amount. After you create a collection, you create one or more form templates for entering and viewing data for the collection. Each data collection period, you create forms from the templates. To create a collection, open supplemental data from the application card. Then select the Collections tab. I'll create a collection for investment details. You have the option to create this collection as a sub-collection. Sub-collections allow you to obtain detailed data collections. You create a sub-collection for an existing collection, which then becomes the parent collection. The sub-collection is linked to the parent collection and displays under the parent collection. You can create a maximum of 5 sub-collections for a parent collection. I want to create this as a collection, so I'll deselect sub-collection. For parent collections, associated sub-collections would be displayed here. Collection intervals allow you to customize your data collections by tailoring the POV to your specific collection needs. Collection intervals use frequency dimensions to define the frequency of the data collection process and workflow dimensions to define the number of workflow instances for data collection. I'll select the default collection interval included within the service. The default collection interval includes year, period, and scenario as the frequency dimensions and entity as the workflow dimension. For shared data records among templates or forms, the default selection is yes, which means the data is shared among templates and forms within the same workflow selection. Select no if you do not wish to share the data. Use the Attributes tab to define the attributes for the collection. Entity is a required attribute. It is automatically enabled for workflow and designated as a key identifier. You can select additional attributes from Supplemental Data Dimensions and Financial Consolidation and Close Dimensions, or you can create custom attributes. I'll create a custom attribute named Investment ID. You can define attributes as input or calculated. You must enter a formula for calculated attributes. Use the data type property to define the type of data, such as text, number, or date. I'll select text. If you select required, users cannot save their form data until they have entered a value. You can optionally enter a default value in the Use Value field. I'll make investment ID a key identifier. You must have at least one key identifier other than entity. The combination of key identifier attributes creates a unique ID for each record in the collection. I'll add a numeric attribute for book value. I'll format the number with 2 decimal places and use a 1000 separator. For numeric attributes, use the total column to specify how to aggregate the data. I'll select sum. You can add data validation to attributes, but you must save the collection first. I'll add validation to the book value attribute to prevent the entry of negative numbers. To do this, I'll add conditions requiring that the values be equal to or greater than 0. You can use attributes of the list data type to create pick lists to assist data entry. I'll add a security type attribute with U.S. Treasury and corporate for choices. You can also add attributes from dimensions. I'll add an attribute from the Standard & Poor's ratings dimension. The key identifier attribute for the dimension is automatically selected. Users are presented with a pick list of values from the dimension when entering data for the attribute. Finally, I'll add an attribute of the date data type for the maturity date. Users can pick a date from a calendar when they enter values. You can use the up and down arrows to change the order of the attribute. I'll move book value to the bottom. When you are finished adding attributes, click Save and Close. The collection is visible in the list. To learn more, visit docs.oracle.com.